get loose and produce.
Do your drums sound lame because you only use samples from EDM packs? Well, don't worry. Today, I'm gonna show you how you can take this simple acoustic snare sample and, using some effects, turn it into something that's ready for your dance music productions. Step 1. Assign your sample to a mixer channel. I've called mine Source, and add some effects. First, let's use an EQ to boost the fundamental frequency and also gently cut some ascending high frequencies. The more you do it, the more intense it is. This is known as attenuation. Fancy. Next, let's add some saturation. For this tutorial, I added a preset in FabFilter Saturn called Acoustic Drum Temper. Let's check it out. Sounds like, but that's okay. We're only on step 1. Step 2. Let's remove the master bus send from our source channel and reroute it to 3 auxiliary bus channels. 1, 2, 3. Sweet. Each one of our bus channels will have a different function. Let's check them out. The first channel I've named Punch, and guess what? We're gonna isolate the punch from the drum sound. Roll off some high end, but be gentle. Any steep slopes will sound like sh. Next, let's add some aggressive compression, super low threshold, and a delayed attack time to make sure the punch can cut through before the compressor does its thing. Oh, that's punchy. Lastly, let's use a gate to remove the tail from our punch. Ultra punchy. Cool, let's move on. This channel is called Crush because I'm gonna distort it even more. Slap on a distortion and distort the living shit out of the signal. Holy crap, that's distorted. Third bus channel, I've called it Extra Room. You guessed it, we're gonna slap on a reverb to add some more texture to our snare. I'm using a basic convolution reverb, but any reverb will do. Be creative. Last, sweep out some low frequencies. We don't need those in our reverb. And automate some volume out of the attack part of our sound. Reverby. Step 3. Mix the signals from the 3 bus channels we've just created into 1 final group channel. You can see my punch has much higher volume than the distortion channel and the reverb. Of course, make sure your bus channels are no longer ascending to the master bus. Cut some low end, some high end, and I've boosted slightly around 4,000 or 5,000 Hz because that's where the energy of drum sounds is for the human ear. Next, you need to remove ultra high frequencies from the attack of the drum sound. You can use automation, but I'm using a volume shaper. Ultra high frequencies in the attack part of your drum sounds make them sound clicky and not nice. And finally, a last bit of compression to squeeze together the 3 signals that we're sending to this bus channel, and an extra gate to clip off the remainder of the tail. That's heavy. Before I go, let's check out one final trick. If I add a frequency shifter on my source channel, I'll be able to affect the pitch before all the effects. This is really dope. Congratulations, you just became a much less successful version of Jack U. Great success. As always, drop a comment if you have any requests, and we'll see you next time on Get Loose and Produce. Peace.